Hello friends, welcome back. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of Excel tutorial. So today I am going to discuss about VLOOKUPs. So VLOOKUP is a very important formula which is available on Excel. So what is VLOOKUP? VLOOKUP is a Excel formula which is used to get values from another or same Excel sheet on the behalf of any common condition between these Excel sheets. What it means? Let's see here. So this is our scenario by which you can see it contains two different Excel sheets. First Excel sheet contains the data information of employee and second Excel sheet contains the information of department. So we want apply VLOOKUP between these two Excel sheets and we want get the output. In our output you can see we want one more column in our Excel sheet 1 for the employee information and we want add department name from department information on the behalf of department ID. As I have told you, there is a requirement by which a common column should be available between these two Excel sheets. And you can see here, department ID is available for these two Excel sheets for the getting information from another sheet. So let's move to Excel. So we can see how we can apply VLOOKUP and we will get the result. So here we can apply VLOOKUP. This is our first Excel sheet and in this Excel sheet you can see it contains the information of employee and this is our another Excel sheet where it contains the information of department. So we want apply VLOOKUP between these two Excel sheet and in employee we want department name as a additional column from department and on the behalf of department ID. So there is a requirement by which we are going to apply VLOOKUP. So this is our requirement. On the behalf of we want to get the data, that column should be available always in left side. And we want the data, that column should be available always in right side. This is our requirement. If this will not be available, then you cannot apply VLOOKUP. So we want department name, so it is available on right side. On the behalf of department ID, we want to get the department name, so it is available on left side. So this is going to fulfill our requirement. So I am going to apply VLOOKUP. We can apply VLOOKUP on the behalf of there is two method to apply VLOOKUP. So our first method is you can click on this insert function. When we click on insert function, there is a lot of functions available. All the functions those are available in our Excel. So we want apply VLOOKUP. So we can select VLOOKUP and then click OK. When we are going to click OK, then you can see there is another window has been opened and in this window you can see lookup value. So lookup value should be that value by which on the behalf of we want get the data. So we want get the data on the behalf of department ID. So we have to select the department ID from our employee table and then go to our table array. Table array is our second table which is our department. So we want to get the data of department name on the behalf of department ID. So we have to select all the information from department ID to that column by which we want to get the data. We want our department name. So it will available on second column. So we have to select first and only second column. If department name would available on third column, then we have to select first, second and third. And then column index number. Column index number our 2 for this case and then range lookup. Range lookup is a optional parameter you can skip. I will explain the later in this video session what is the range lookup. For not time being I am going to skip. Then click on OK. When you are going to click OK, then you can see there is a department name of sale is available. So department ID is 1 and then department name is sale and you can verify from department Excel sheet. So here department ID is 1 and then department name is sales. So it will going to result as it is we want. So we can scroll and we can see all the department name is available on the behalf of department ID from department table. Our second method, you can type formula. You have, when you are going to type formula, you have to apply equal to then formula name. So I am going to apply VLOOKUP. Then we have to select VLOOKUP. Then it will ask from lookup value. So lookup value should be department ID from employee Excel sheet. Then we have to put comma, then table array. As I have explained in our method 1, table array, we have to select all the columns from starting to by which we want to get the data. So this is our second position. So we have to select index value should be 2, and then third optional parameter you can skip. Once you are going to click OK, then it will reflect the result. So this is our output, and now you can see here, as I have explained. So thank you so much for watching this video.